because I think a lot of the challenges are very similar in a way. We have, I mean, we cannot disagree that there are specific UK-specific challenges that influence the national healthcare system and that will have an influence on how predictive, preventive, and personalised medicine is implemented. And these are related to the structure, these are related to the economics, these are related to sort of like politics and the sort of like driving ideologies of politics behind them, who the government is and what they want to do. But there are a number of challenges, I think. Again, not similar to what we had earlier, and I'm sure they're not very similar to what we would hear related from other representatives. And there are more than sort of like the disease type or medicine-related challenges. We all know and talk about increasing life expectancy and this, how this will influence the incidence of cancer and other chronic diseases. And we all know and discuss things of the negative influence of lifestyle and environment. I think disturbingly, we all talk about how health inequalities are increasing. And I think the interesting point in the UK, and maybe it's the same elsewhere, it has been shown that actually it is the health of the rich people that is increasing at a much faster rate than the health of the poor people. And that to me would imply that we need maybe approaches beyond health. And as we heard yesterday in the Springer lecture, the World Health Organization are advocating the open access to a lot of the published literature, and they say this will help decrease by allowing developing countries to access better literature, more literature, it will help decrease their inequality gap. And then we have challenges that are due to how the systems change and transform and becoming adapted to the times of believing. We know that the healthcare is now being delivered less and less in the hospital and goes up to the community and even in people's homes. And we understand and how healthcare is changing because of the pressures of regulation and actually how healthcare is funded and increase in painful performance and elective issues. So in terms of conclusions and in concluding, I think there's a very little we can argue with that preventive and preventive and increasingly predictive and personalised medicine are becoming part of routine disease and health management within the UK healthcare system. The second point there, I think, is just to highlight the fact that circles outside academia and medical circles are becoming to take notice of personalised medicine and prevention, predictions, and all the things part of what we're doing. In terms of personalised medicine, the 2009 UK Parliament Office Science and Technology Government Body report concluded that economic incentive, regulation of biological tests, and medical education will increase the rate and degree to which personalised medicine will be incorporated into drug development and clinical practice. And this, to me, this makes complete sense. And actually, I think that's totally true. I think the point that I would like to stress here is the role of education. The role of education, I think, is paramount. And I mean education not just at the professional level, for like medics, healthcare professionals, government bodies, regulators, more and more, but education of the public and understanding what actually healthcare is, personalised medicine is, and what are the implications for them. And thank you all very much for listening.